everyone, and welcome back to our channel. In this week's video, I'll walk you through all of the major updates and news that have been made within Zoho ecosystem and within Zoho apps. Before I begin this video, please make sure to subscribe to our channel and click the notification button not to miss any useful information that we share here every single week. So Zoho constantly works on updating their software, adding new exciting features. And today I want to talk about all the exciting updates and new features that have been added within Zoho so you can know about them and use them for the needs of your business. And we'll start off as usually from the core of any business, Zoho CRM, and the updates that have been made within Zoho CRM. So in Zoho CRM, there's a lot of new features. For example, Microsoft Teams phone system now integrates with Zoho CRM for tasks like dialing numbers and logging calls. You can now quickly migrate attachments to Zoho CRM without having to restart the process multiple times. Zoho CRM also introduced previous and next operators for enhanced date-based filtering. Ask Zia in Zoho CRM also got a huge update. You can now chat with Zia using three distinct message intents: insights, help, and action, each of which is designed to support your unique CRM journey. Another great update within Zoho is that team spaces and team modules have been added to Zoho CRM mobile app. These two features are new to Zoho CRM as a part of Zoho CRM for Everyone update. So team spaces are dedicated workspaces that enable each team to operate independently while staying connected. And with team modules, teams can create and configure their own modules to carry out their day-to-day tasks and responsibilities. And to help teams coordinate, the new feature of requesters have been also added to Zoho CRM. You can also now easily use shortcuts in Zoho CRM and organize your modules into folders. Zoho CRM also added very useful ways to view your data: a chart view, a grid view, a timeline view, and a split view. Another great feature that has been added to Zoho CRM is interactions tab that offers a chronological view of each customer's journey and interactions across various channels in your CRM. And another update in UI of Zoho CRM, you can now use a dark mode to view your data. Another update in Zoho CRM is in Canvas, so you can now add lookup module fields to Canvas detail view page and Canvas list view page. And another great update is that cross-module criteria is now supported in Zoho CRM in custom views. So with the new cross-module criteria support, you can easily refine your records based on related modules and subforms. Some other updates in Zoho CRM include sending emails directly via cases modules, a new component in Canvas in Zoho CRM Flex that helps you create customizable and adaptive design, and a new feature of detecting anomalies in user performance is available with sales forecasting.
As you can see, Zoho has made a lot of exciting updates within Zoho CRM, and we'll be moving to see the updates that have been made in other sales apps.
From other sales apps, I want to highlight Begin because it got a lot of different updates. For example, now you have an option to log incoming phone calls in the Begin Android app. Another great new feature in Zoho Begin is Lead Chain that helps you to synchronize leads from different social media ads, from Facebook, LinkedIn, TikTok, WhatsApp, and Google Ads. And the last update in Zoho Begin is a brand new integration with QuickBooks.
Now let's move on from sales apps to marketing apps and see what updates have been made there.
Starting off from Zoho Social, now you can manage and respond to comments on your threads post from inbox. Analyze what matters and what's trending through details hashtag report. You can reply to your Instagram and Facebook comments privately through direct messages, manage Facebook ad comments from your inbox, include popular hashtags in your captions, and transform any URL into a shareable image with a sneak peek at its content.
Moving on to the finance apps and see what updates the apps has gotten.
Starting off from Zoho Books, you can now use export transaction in Factor X format in Global Edition, manage TCS rates and download self-invoice in India Edition, configure webhook retry policy, set up custom notifications for API limits, customize page number format for PDF templates, customize and view stock status for items in transaction, display type for lookup custom fields, set up module level approval, add payment mode and bank account details to transactions in Germany Edition. You can also filter and add reporting tags as columns, filter and view sales orders that are not shipped, allocate landed costs to multiple bills,
use chain comparators in workflow rules, upload images from your desktop to email templates, apply line item discounts with Avalara integration in United States and Canada edition, and use support for local taxes in Mexico edition. Also, there is a new feature of record income TDS without linking it to an invoice in India and global editions. You can also now mark PDF templates as active or inactive, configure workflow rules based on organization or customer time zone, use WhatsApp notification support for packages and shipments, use sales summary report, and sort and limit data points in report panels. Moving on to Zoho Payroll that has got a lot of updates specifically in US edition. So now you can extend the deadline to approve your pay run, change payment mode to check while processing pay runs, share screen recordings with Zoho support team, use multi-state payroll, multiple pay rates for employees, custom roles, reporting tax for smarter payroll insights, manage different documents using bonus payroll and off-cycle payroll, get instant bank account verification for direct deposits with Played In, all in US edition. Zoho has also introduced a brand new app, Zoho Payments, with which you can accept payments, receive payouts, track reports, and manage disputes. Moving on to Zoho Expense that has a new feature of real-time feeds, so you can now connect your corporate cards and record expenses in Zoho Expense as and when you make a purchase. And the last app on this list is Zoho Commerce that got a huge update. Now there's a lot of new features like abandoned cart recovery, wish lists, loyalty programs, workflow automations, and smart coupons.
Now let's move on to service apps and see what new features Zoho brings for us within this category.
So Zoho Desk has got a lot of useful updates that includes a new sign-in flow for the help center that is more secure and easier to use. Zoho Desk also introduced a new feature, Playground, an inclusive proactive testing environment for businesses to analyze Zia's prediction accuracy. And Zoho Desk also got an app update for Android. You can now access the guided conversation bots in the instant messaging module.
It's time to move on to email and collaboration apps and see what features have been added there.
Starting off from Zoho Backstage, and Zoho Backstage Organizer app now supports SoonMe smart mobile terminals. Also, Zoho Backstage got some other updates and new functions. For example, now you can use automated refunds with cancellation fee deductions, export attendee data with deleted fields, add attachments to scheduled emails, enable or disable workflows during event creation, use module-specific primary contacts, make offline payments with visuals and verification, recover lost registrations with win-back emails, and directly convert approval requests to orders. Moving on to Zoho WorkDrive that got a huge update, and with a new version of 5.0, you can automate your content workflows, classify and protect sensitive data, enforce folder-level access control in team folders, secure your digital assets with watermarks, use granular control over external file sharing, whitelist domains and email addresses, view and remove share permissions in bulk, experience AI-powered transcription, extract key insights, and enable multilingual collaboration with Zia, optimize storage with smart file version controls, create a central hub for essential files, and leverage built-in image annotator. And Zoho also introduced a brand new app, Zoho Translate, that can help you translate text, audio, and images all in one place.
Moving on to HR and project management apps, and see if there's any new updates there.
Starting off from Zoho Workerly that got two new updates to simplify your shift planning. So now you can toggle between weekly and monthly roster views, and you can create shifts on unavailable days without removing the data manually. Moving on to Zoho Recruit that got a small update, so Zoho has renamed the custom from address to organization email. And moving on to Zoho Projects that also got a small update, now you can set conditional and dependent rules for issues in Zoho Projects.
And now let's move on to developer apps and analytics and see what updates these apps have gotten.
So Zoho Analytics has gotten a few updates that include the what-if analysis in AutoML. You can also use hourly data syncs for business app connectors in Zoho Analytics now, and there have also been some enhancements in Python conditional formatting. So as you can see, Zoho apps have got a lot of different useful updates. And now when you know about new features, you can use them and utilize using them for making your business and using Zoho more effective. And if you want to stay up to date with all of the Zoho news, I would highly recommend subscribing to our newsletter and also following us on social media, because we share different exciting news and updates of Zoho there regularly. And also, obviously, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, because we make these compilations of all of the useful Zoho news and updates within every quarter of every year. Also, if you have any questions about Zoho implementation, customization, or integration, I would highly recommend booking a free consultation with one of our experts by the link down below in the description box. You can ask any questions about Zoho, its new features, or any integration or implementation process, and we will answer all of them and consult you. If you have any additional questions, you can also leave them in the comments down below, and we will answer to all of them. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that it was helpful for you and will help you to use Zoho more effectively. And I will see you in the next week's video.